sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman, the host of the Tiger Technician's Hour and the author of the Opening Call Daily Newsletter. And this is going to be quite a difficult period for two reasons. One is, if you've been along for a while and you've seen very good gains, and we're now bumping into certain resistance levels, if the stocks that you have are still acting very well, what do you do? Do you get out of everything and say, hey, let's start fresh if there's a big pullback? Or do you whittle away, try to build up some capital, just kind of kitty, so that you can put money to work? This is a period of thinking right now. Yes, if you have very low price stocks, I've got a whole chunk that I'm going to talk about in a moment, screamers, I call them. That's one thing, because that's a completely different mindset. But if you are a position player and you are a trader, how do you mix the two things? So I'll try to get to that between today and tomorrow when I have my Friday, more technical Friday called ChapmanWave Friday. In the meantime, let's look at this. The Dow's up 9 at 28,278. What do we always look for in the ChapmanWave methodology? We look for, I'll just drive this, draw it across here. There it is. For those of you new to my work, all I'm doing is I'm trying to, and I've done this for decades, try to find the lowest, most identifiable low bar in which to start a buy signal that can be upgraded to a buy mode. I count the peaks on the upside. Each higher peak is alphabetized sequentially, and you can go all the way to a G, the seventh highest peak, but it's at the fourth highest peak, peak A, B, C, D, peak D, that you have to lift your foot off the accelerator, hover over the break, and just take a moment to say, are we going to recycle to another whole series of up moves, or is this a bigger move to the downside? Just real simple, ABCD gets you there, then you've got to make some decisions. Once you make those decisions, you're in play for the next phase. All right, so where are we? We're in that leg D right now, and it's the second buy mode since the day of the low, March the 23rd. But we were long, we're still long via call options. But most importantly, we went long the diamonds at 210. That's about 21,000, just under 21,000. We're at 26,268. What did we do? So the only thing I could do, since I'll explain why, but I'll explain also what we're doing, is to get some insurance. So I've taken, we're short a particular index, one-to-one. I don't want to interfere with the Dow. So the Dow, we've only got long positions. I don't want to have two mindsets here. And people say, oh, you're long, you're short. Yeah, we're long. We've got only long positions. We have set up yesterday at the open, we set up a short position that is basically, first of all, an insurance. And within a day or two, I'll know whether to increase that and maybe even take something off our long position in the Dow. And we're starting just to whittle away tiny little bits of our long positions because we all reached peak Ds, leg Ds, and probably peak Ds in almost all of them. So with that said, I'll just make it real clear. A punch from here at 26,000, let's call it 300, into the 26,800 area, not only would be extremely bullish, but it would take the S&P up, and the SP right now also in leg D, also just struggling. It could be a peak D if there's no high above 30.94, yesterday's high. And that would fit exactly with the sequence that we're looking for, this rotation to highs. And the MACD is very strong. Stochastic's fabulous at 97.09, 3% off the, less than 3% off the 100% level, which is never hit in this particular stochastic. On the outer levels, 100% and 0%, it's between 80 and 20 that things happen, and it's at 97. So to actually get this negative, you'd have to go to the 200-period moving average of 29.51. And I have to tell you, it's going to take not just bad news, but over and over, repeated out throughout the day, the bad news that the market takes as bad news. Doesn't say, ho hum, that's yesterday's news. I'm looking out. This is the one that says, I'm looking now, and I'm coming down. So far, we don't have it. Now, here comes the thing. Congratulations to our Denner, Pete Deeb, who's been saying for a long time, as a Chapman waiver, that we should make leg D in the QQQs above 237.47, the high of February of 2020. What's the high today? 237.79. So that's the V-shaped pattern. I'm going to take a little time today and tomorrow to talk about this V-shaped pattern, what are the implications, etc., in the weekly chart, because it's gone to a new high, and it went to a lower low than the starting point of the last weekly buy mode back in, that was back in August, week of the 9th of August at 179.28 was the low. It went under it for that smash to the downside, 30%, down to 164 in March. So that says this is a brand new leg B. We're in a buy mode. It means that based on this particular technique, it could fail. But right now, at this point, until it goes to a leg D, there's zero chance of going to 164.93. But remember, this is just a technique. It's not the technique. It's not the one that came down in the golden script or something like that. It is just a technique. It says, if there is a major slide to the 222 level of the 9-period exponential moving average or 218, the 14-period moving average, okay, that could be a pretty serious decline from 235 to 218. Give back the last 4 weeks of gains, 3-4 weeks. That's less. It's about 3 weeks. But at the same time, that would be quite serious. For the Qs to go into the 242 area, to say to 237, goodbye, I'm done, I'm on my way up, would be extremely positive and raise the base of support considerably, as well as if on a weekly on a two-week basis, I'm sorry, not 1 week, on a two-week basis, if there is a two-week close above 238, 237.47 was the last high. So if it's a little bit above that for 2 weeks, I'd have to say that that is a breakout of considerable importance. All right, let's go to the IWM. IWM right now with the Dow down 0.02%, the S&P down 0.3%, the IWM is down 0.28%, struggling a little bit, but it is a, but just remember, I make a big deal about the 200-period moving average. You look here in the daily, when it becomes you can actually see it going seesawing over and under and over and under. And that just tells me that for the IWM, the 148.25 area is extremely strong resistance. And the 138 area, 140 to 138 is extremely important and it should be good support. So it's stuck in a range. I think we're getting to that range right now. Hey, let's go to gold. Gold is up 16. Yesterday it was down sharply. It went and tested successfully so far the low that was made in April of 1688.8. Yesterday's low was 1690.3. So far, inside bar, that rectangle is continuing. Let's just look at the dollar before we go on. We've got a break coming up here. I wanted to show you the E-minis. Dollar went to a lower low. It's at 96.88, down 45. Very weak. I'll be right back. Down.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
So talking chart pattern, you know the chart pattern I call the lowercase h, what happens, you come down sharply and then you make a little h pattern, you make another h, that lowercase h can go to lowercase m, that forms a rectangle pattern. Well, that's what we saw in the dollar and was holding very well for ages. Look, DXY. It was just lowercase h goes to lowercase m, and then there was a large one right here, and it broke down. And what happens when you break down from this pattern, you can go like a propeller shaft from the high that was made, the previous high, in this case, the dollar 102.99, down to the low of 98.27, and then it rallies up, it makes the rectangle a resistance line, and it keeps holding the support. When it breaks the support, you can have a one-to-one to the downside. Propeller shaft, this whole thing has the shaft. Not exactly, I wouldn't like to ride in a plane that has a kind of propeller shaft, but you know what I mean. This is the fulcrum, and you make an equal move to the downside, which is what we're doing. We're getting really close to trying to find some support, but it doesn't seem to me that the dollar at this particular... This is kind of what the Fed wanted in a way. They're kind of getting it. But I would just consider it as a big consolidation after that huge doji candle, long-legged doji candle from way back in, I should know the date, surely, because we are long this, from March of 2020, makes a high of 102.99, and that same month it had a low of 94.85, one of the biggest candles you'll ever see in the dollar index. Up until now, that is. So this is it in the pattern I like to look at. Look, think of this as the upside-down rectangle that I talk about. You remember, I talk about it in my webinar. I did this whole thing a week ago. I did the webinar. It's still online. I mean, if you want to check it out, I like what I did there. I wanted to cover what we're looking at here, why we're looking at it, and the patterns that I think are going to be pertinent for the next few months. So this pattern now is the upside-down rectangle. So I would have said, if this was the top and that was the bottom, I would have said we could make a kind of a U-shaped formation working its way in a peak, peak ABCD, almost to just under or just above, and then come back down. So now it's upside down. It says you can go to the 95, 93, 200 period moving average, And then you could start a nice bounce in the middle again. So dollar's weak, and it should remain a week, a little longer. It's trying to bounce. Let me just do this a quest because I might forget. Hi, Basil. I've been loading up on NBEV, a possible screamer since April, playing it like a non-expiring option, waiting for it to scream. So I'm just going to do this. NBEV, I'm going to get to silver. I don't want to be interrupted in my train of thought on this particular stock because it's a pattern that I'm talking about. Look, it's the inversion of what we were looking at. Look, screams to the downside and then bounces up. So it's now making you can call it a cup formation, but first you've got to think of it as a rectangle because it stopped on the way up. So the candles are not making the V-shaped formation. They've gone sideways. So NBEV says, I'm stuck in a rectangle formation. I'm trading at 1.69. I'm called New Age Beverage Corp. Monthly chart is horrible, but there is a doji, a silent doji from 3 months ago. That's going to be important if this thing could ever not break the low of one, but keep going to the 238 level. That'll be really positive in the monthly. Weekly chart says, wait a minute. How can you be thinking monthly without looking at the weekly, obviously? So this is new. I'm putting an up arrow, but I can say I'm putting in, I haven't got the notation, but I'm just putting in a plus sign to say we've started a buy signal. And that buy signal has gone to peak A and a peak B, and then it's stalled. But wait a minute, you've got another little A underneath. Remember, in the Chapman wave, your only obligation is to count each peak and trough. So now you've made another leg B. If this B continues up, it goes to a C above that left side high. If it stalls for another week and then goes to a leg C and that leg C takes out the old B, you've got yourself an overlapping wave here that's really powerful. It says not only should it go to a C, and I'll give you the number, but if it doesn't have to close, it just has to go above 1.88, goes to 1.89. If it does it now, you've gone to leg C. If it waits another week or so, stalling before it gets there, makes a peak B and a great B, I call it a great peak B, and then you break to the upside, that's even more positive because that says, finally, you're out of the range. Now, look how many times it's had from the low. In this case, I am putting an up arrow because it's had so many tries and it's done quite well, and the MACD is good, and the stochastic's at 72%. It's okay. Look at the on-balance volume. Very good. So New Age BEV, NBEV, trading at 169, up 6 cents. That's 4% when you're playing games with these little things. Anything can make a big percentage gain. But now look what happens. It goes peak A, peak B, pulls back sharply, like a restart. The Eiffel Tower, single leg A pullback, except it happens to be B. And the MACD is improving, the stochastic's improving. It holds beautiful support. The low was 0.98 or something. Yeah, 0.98. And then the low that of this time was 0.102, 4 cents higher. And then what does it do? It screams above that peak B. It takes this peak B and it doubles. So you've got an overlapping wave. Bam, leg C. But it then pulled back very much inside because it's a takeoff. This is part of the restart in my CD introducing the Chapman wave methodology. I talk about the restart, and it does it again. It goes peak A, peak B, pulls back. Peak A, peak B, and now it's in leg C. If it doesn't make a new high today, recovery high, that's a peak C. If that then takes out 1.76, there's a good chance it's going to try in one quick swoop to tag the high that was made at 188 on the 14th of April. And if it goes above that in leg D, that's going to be a sharp move to the upside. And what you've done is you've turned this high into the first key support of 188. But this high that was made yesterday, if this becomes the high for the day of 174, and you're at 169 right now, so you can easily take it out. But that becomes the next level of support. So I like it. I like your plan. But I'm just, when you said I've been loading up, all I'm going to say is this. I don't want you to put, waiting for it to scream upward. Oh, there it is. I didn't read the rest because this is exactly what I was going to talk about. It's wearing on my patience. What are your thoughts? When will this BEV breakout topside? Thanks. So Hector, this is really important. This is a base of support. I'm actually with you. Normally, I would say I like the term loading up. I remember I've done this before in my own. I haven't done it for a long time. I've also done the loading up. What happens when you load up is you kind of saying you're like teasing the stock. You're saying, hey, watch this. You don't know it, but I think you're going much higher, and I'm just going to buy. And the stock doesn't care. It doesn't know who you are. It's going to do what it's going to do. So you do your technical analysis. All I wanted to say is, when you say load it up, I hope it is still only a part of your portfolio. I don't think this is going to go right now, go back to the 120 or the $1 area. It looks like it's building a higher base. But I'm not the star. I have no idea. I'm just saying the chart says it shouldn't. So just be careful. If you could handle another pullback to $1.40, that's 30 cents from where we are, and still not feel any qualms at all, that's fine. If it had to go under 140 and you got nervous, just put it that way. Where would I not want it to go? And what would I do if it did that? Would I add more? Remember, doubling down, tripling down, quadrupling down is the worst tactic. That must have been your plan, that you were going to add to it because you really like it, and these are the levels you'd add.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. I just want to finish that up. So NBEV trading at 169, up 6, is held very nice and steady. I would prefer if today it doesn't make a peak, it actually extends leg C by going not to 188, but go 174, but to 175 or higher. That would really be good. But I do want to emphasize, if it pulled back and it broke key support of, say, 148, what would you feel? Would it, a frustration, I don't care about frustration, but would you lose sleep? Anything that has to do with that, you've got to lighten up. You could add on the way up and you miss a nice percentage gain, but you're at least going to higher highs and higher lows. Now, I just wanted to say, I don't mind anything, but if this is only part of your portfolio, I think you're doing this is a plan that on this particular stock, it's building the kind of level of support in that whole 140s area that says it should not break down below that. If it does, that's a real problem. But the weekly also is starting to build technical strength. I like it. I think you're right. But I just got a little worried when you said loaded up. Okay, a couple of questions I had. I wanted to get to silver here. I didn't do that. Silver trading right now down a little bit from yesterday, from 2 days ago. It had a sharp pullback from that leg E, made a peak E at 19. No, it was just under 19. It was 18. This is a continuous contract. Yeah, 18.90. So 18.90. And the next day it has a high of 18.95. And then the next day it has 18.90. So ChapmanWave two bar reversal, peak E. MACD's just about to cross negative, but still good. Stochastics at 82%, still good, but turning down. On balance volumes, not that great. Relative strength is good, but turning down. So this says silver could have a bit of a break here in terms of time, but it's price-wise. You know, this weekly chart is still, look at that, you broke out, you're coming back to test the ChapmanWave inside track support, you've got support all the way down to 1739, the 200 premium. I would welcome a little breather here. I would not welcome it if it takes time and makes a head, left side shoulder, and then a right shoulder, and then takes out 1660 support. That'll say, silver's now taking a really good timeout. Right now, it's just taking a rest. It's had a spectacular move. So would I add to it for a breakout? Personally, for my subscribers, we're holding back. I've missed the move up. I think there'll be another opportunity. So I'm just saying we've had some really nice stocks. What can I say? I missed the move. I spoke about it. We just didn't get in correctly. So, yeah, silver and gold, I think just taking a well-earned breather. I just go back to the dollar now just to show you something interesting. Dollar trading at 96.80, down in leg E. This is like 8 or 9 sessions without lower lows and lower highs. It's that little worm pattern. Remember, we look at it sometimes on the upside. Here it is on the downside. So remember, the one-to-one pattern says you could, in fact, go down to the 96.40s, maybe even a tad lower. But if you break under that, then that 95, 93, 200 moving average just beckoning for you to come there. I think there'll be a little bit of a bounce beforehand. Most importantly, what I am looking at here is we had a question of APDN. I think I missed the question in the den before that, but I'll do it. APDN trading at 786 down 50 cents. Wow, look at this. Gap up, U-shaped pattern. Gap up, U-shaped pattern. Gap up, U-shaped pattern. Gap up, no U-shaped pattern. It's spiked. Look at that. This is like, this is what you see in biotech sometimes on a monthly basis. And not so much now, but it used to be that they would pay in option calls or in stock. And you would see systematically these, like this big leg to the upside pops over 18 in the month of the week. Pops up over 18 and then closes the week. Starts off the week at 4. It opens at $5.01, screams up to $19.69, and then says, "Oops, maybe someone thought I was Apple or something and pressed the wrong symbols," because it suddenly plunges and it goes down, hits a low of 4.20 and closes at 4.43. So that's what you would see consistently every month at the beginning or the end or some on a regular basis whenever they wanted to pay their employees, and they didn't have cash, they'd pay them in these options or they'd pay them in stock. And that's what you'd see. So all I can say is this one now has failed in the usual number of the bars have been shrinking and shrinking for the cup formation, and it's trading 787, and just the other day it was $16. And what did we say? $16 and something and 39 cents. I would say that's a little bit of a pullback. be careful. That's all I can say. Maybe you're right because there's an FDA report or something. This is Applied DNA Sciences, APDN, trading at $7.87, down 49 cents. Be careful of this stuff. CHWY says, okay. Yeah, this is a nice pattern. Look, it made a low. That was a peak A. It was actually on my list as a potential stock and just kind of got away. And when things get away, sometimes it's difficult to reorient your thoughts to say, oh, it's still good. Why should you worry about the price if you think it's going higher? But you're worried that you're going to buy in and you'll buy at the top. So there makes the peak D. It does pull back sharply. And then all of a sudden, in the 46s, it drops down to the 37s and now it's trading at 49, had a new recovery high, a new all-time high. Oh, Chewy Inks. Oh, that's why I knew this one so well. Pet supplies. Remember, for my subscribers, I've had a couple of pet projects here. That is pet supplies, Chewy. There was another one. Was that PETS? PETS. You know, the general public, pets. Yeah, this is pets something or other. Pet Med Express, trading at 34. People don't give up for their pets. And I don't think I've ever seen that this many people walking around with dogs. And it was just unbelievable. And not just dogs. These are expensive dogs because you can't just go out and get a dog these days. You have to get a, you know, it has to be the Ferrari or the Porsche of dogs. Yeah, so dog supply is low. All I can say is that I'm looking at this and I think that the last thing people will give up, they'll give up their cosmetics before they will give up for their dogs. So Chewy, I think this is a play right now at 49.59, an all-time high. Well, this is a single leg A to the upside. Yeah, this is a brand new B. It's a leg B in the monthly chart. It's only a leg B in the weekly chart. I'm going to say, if you are looking at this, as I think you are, the question is, as a long-term play at 49.67, I'm saying start your position. Would you add to an existing position right here? You're right here expecting that it will pull back, probably about a point or so, because it could be forming a spike here, and then it has to get back into the body of trading. So you could wait. But in your case, I don't think a point is going to make too much difference. So I'm just saying, yeah, I like this. In your particular methodology of looking out longer term, start a position small right here, and let's see if we can get to the 41 or even the 35 area. And that means 49 to 35, 14 points. That's not what most people would put up, but you're looking longer term. If you're a short-term trader, risk-reward here says a point up, point and a half, but maybe 3 points down, you've got to wait. So I hope that solves it for you. But I if you're looking out, buy a call option for August or something on this. And trade it by in the money, deep in the money, in fact. That's a much better way. I'll be back in a moment. Dow's down 64, S&P's down 14. Basil Chapman, I'll talk about the market in a minute.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A shares hot or not?
If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Okay, I had a bunch of things that I wanted to do. I've written them all down. But believe me, I think it's, for me, doing the show right now, I think it's way more important just for me to explain my positioning and why the position is there. First of all, the five-minute chart, look, it ran beautifully from the 3,093-ish area all the way up to the 3,125, 3,126, I think it was, 75 high. Peak E, remember the Chapman Wave? There's the D on the left, a little short one in ABCD. Pulls back, now it's a bigger one. And now you're making this arch formation. But look how much time you've used in trying to get to the low. You've used, you know, if I count the bars, let's just say it's 18 bars up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 bars down. It takes you to about here. And we hit the 200 period moving average. We try to keep that as support. Now it's resistance at 3109. And we're at 3105. So we've used up time, but we haven't broken down at the same speed and angle as you went up. And that says, okay, there are buyers out there that keep wanting to buy that have missed the market. And that's the reason why in our positions, I didn't want to get too carried away. I didn't want to overshort. I didn't want to get out of our long positions and say, okay, we're done. This is it. Nobody can tell. Why? Because when you make a V-shaped formation, now I'm going to go back to the charts. When you make a QQQ, right? Yeah, the QNDX 100, 1, 2, 3. When you retest, as you did, I'll show you. There it is. So here's your December. So you go from 187-ish in October of 2018 to 143. Big move, 44 points. Okay, pull back, and then you go back to the high. But this time you went above the high. There are examples. I wonder if it's still there. I do it by memory. I think Disney had it. We had that remarkable pullback. And it went almost to the exact price. And I said, that is incredible. Oh, yeah, yeah. It wasn't. There it is. Let me just double check. So Disney makes 122.08 high in August of 2015, plunges down to the 88 area, and then struggles and goes, and the monthly chart goes peak A. And this is back in 2015, 2016. Goes peak A, peak B, peak C, and peak D. And where is peak D? Peak turns out to be after the December low of what? 120.20. And then it takes a breather, and that breather took it down to 100. 20 points, 20%. No, less 16%. So you can see, I take these double tops very seriously, and that's the reason why I've said, because it, this is just one index, and the SMHs, very important semiconductors, made a new recovery high today of 150.18. What was the all-time high? 152.82 with a ChapmanWave two-bar reversal. Back in, this was back in March, I believe it was, right there, March, the week of, I should have put the date, that's the week of the 21st of February, and the very next week of 28th, it makes this double top of what, 10 cents lower. I love this technique. ChapmanWave two-bar reversal, what a plunge from peak E, and it goes 36% down to 96, round number low. I love round numbers. 23rd of, actually it was early, I think it was the 18th, yep, there it is, 18th of March. And what does it do? It comes back, but it hasn't gone to that level. And today it's still up 92 cents. The SMH is, whereas the Dow is down 98, the S&P's down 17, the IWM, did I even, yes, the IWM is down. Let me just put it in here. The IWM is down 121, right at the 200 period moving average resistance. So XLK, together with the SMH, the XLK has made a slightly lower high today for, I'm calling it a peak F for now, if it doesn't make a new high, at 99.93, but yesterday's high was what? Look at this right here. It was at a 99.95. What's the all-time high back in February? 102.94. So it's come within 2 points-ish. 2 points, yeah. Let's call it 3 points. Within 3 points. Having gone from 102.94 down to the low of 75, round number, that wasn't 75, was it? No, that's a different one. That was 68.10. I mean, these are big numbers, 68.10 in the XLK, the S&P Select Tech Sector. So all I can say is there's a chance that we're making some kind of a double top. Slight failure, maybe, or even just like a maybe that we still have to get that one pop to the upside. I'm not interested so much in the one pop to the upside. I'm actually talking about whether or not this is a top that's going to be accompanied by or triggered as a deeper sell by the ChapmanWave. There it is, dark news cloud cover. So let's see if we can get that. And Boeing right now is up 181. It had 186 left side high. Left side high resistance going way back. And then it went to 188 and now it's down off that low. And that's the reason why the market is pulling back. So I drew this in and I said, I'm keeping it. I've raised it by a tad. I had it slightly lighter. Now it's still light, but it's there hovering over. And I will make this darker by next week, I think, if the Dow breaks under 25,700 by sometime next week. And that's going to say to me, okay, we have made a top now, but is it a top of consequence? And we'll only know on how the market and what the news is that's triggering the selling pressure. That's number one. Number two is, I had a list, I wonder if it's changed while I'm talking to you. I had a list of 15, now it's 12, of 15 stocks. You know, I have this thing called screamers. I had a list yesterday, it went from 3 to 0 intraday. It just got evaporated. And this morning, I look, and this has gone from 8, and then, no, 3, and then there were 5. Then it went to 15, and now there are 12. And I'll just give you a couple of names just so that you can look at them. This is one I liked a lot, RWT. I almost put it in for the ChapmanWave, for my opening call subscribers as a screamer. I didn't do it because I really wanted to focus on the market for today and yesterday. I did it over there. Okay, here we go, RWT. Look at this. RWT is, in fact, one of those days. There we go. Look at that. It's up 10%, 6.44. And look, keep an eye on this chart on the left here. Look at this chart here. This is the daily. Look at the pattern. You see this pattern? See a big move up off the low, and then it just failed and made a new low, and then it struggled. That's the Chapman wave restart. Look at Boeing. Where do you think it went? It went to the left. Remember, I had all these different rectangles. I took this away because we were in the narrow one. And then I said, oops, I've got to expand this again. 186.48 was the high that was made after the 89 round number low made back in March. And that was on the 26th of March. And then what does it do? It pulls backward, holds the low. It goes to 113.89. Back on the 14th of May, and today it went just above the 186.48 in the rectangle formation, repelled by the rectangle so far, went to 188.60, and now it is up 8 at 181.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
So this is a really good question. I want to do this real quickly. Hi, Basil. In the beginning of your show today, you were talking about the struggles of what to do with the great return stocks. Isn't that the time you simply look at the weekly and monthly for a decision on holding longer term or not? By the way, in listening to your show, it seems like you've had some really good trades on the low. Okay. So what's really important is, I just wanted to say before I forget, Hector, your NBEV is now up 4 cents instead of up 6 cents. It's at 167. It's still holding well. If it holds well all through the day, and let's just imagine that the market gets weaker through the day, I know, I'm just saying, and your stock holds, that's what you want to see. If it starts to pull back with the market, it's market vulnerable, and you don't want that. You want this to be totally independent. You would actually like to see it by the end of the day at 169 or 171. That'll be really good action. All right, that's number one. Number two is, yes, tomorrow I'll be talking about those weekly and monthly charts. The reason why I'm staying long, we've only just taken a little tad off, is because they've done very well. And most of them look like their weekly charts are really strong. I'll talk about that tomorrow because that's what we want to talk about. How do you go from the daily to the weekly to the monthly? How can you keep positions for a long time? I'll talk about that. The third thing I want to talk about is stay tuned for Steve, Dave, and Tom. They're coming up straight off to my show, and my service is the opening call. Check it out on the front page of TFNN. You get a ton of webinars. Those webinars alone, I'm kind of proud of them, because when I go back and I say, you know, I covered everything I wanted to, I fulfilled what we had to do. It's like an hour and a half lesson I like to give, so that it's for the future. It's not just a one-time thing. Now let me just do this real quickly. The VIX index, as we're about to wrap up, the VIX is trading up 7 cents at 25.73. This is the one thing that's saying to me that the VIX will find some normality at some point, that is, go back to the teens. But we might have raised the level of support. We won't know that. That's why I don't always give numbers out of my techniques, because they change over the years. But in this particular instance, I don't think we're going to change that much. I think we still have to be looking at a pullback into the teens. Says this is really good for the market. And if we start to see the VIX index at any point a week from tomorrow, give it a full week next week, if at any point it hits 28.5 to 31, I think we're looking at a pullback that might be a little more meaningful. I'm worried we've got 15 of these screamers lined up. That means people are in this. They are reckless at this point.